fan of modern country. I like the older stuff, and I'll play some more stuff here a little bit later on, but I like some Luke Combs. He's got some good stuff. There's one thing I really despise, and that's artists that use their positions for political gain, you know, make political statements when they do their music. I despise it. So I'm going to do it anyway. This is called Throne. This is the original. One more time is one too long. I've lived it face to face. Half-hearted hatred is just a big disgrace. There's too many people wanting something that serves them. I like to know the stories behind the songs. Anybody interested in hearing the stories behind songs that are written? Some of them have no stories. Some of them just fall out of you. some just fall out of you, and sometimes I have a song coming up later that I really feel like sometimes God gives us things that we are supposed to pass on to somebody else, but it's not necessarily the present time. We have a really cool story about one of those songs here later on, but this is actually kind of a fun song. My wife is probably like a lot of wives out there. She loves to watch too much Hallmark, and whenever the notebook's on, she thinks she's got to watch it 100 times, so any chick flick, you know, I'm usually in the other room. So this is something I just thought of one day. I thought, you know, what if you were missing your wife? What would you do? And there's nothing on TV, but all those shows that she normally watches is on. So this song's called The Female Side. Songs in 4 minutes. Okay? Alright, one after, just right at each other, okay? So come along with me for the ride. Thank you. somebody clock me?
I wondered if you did.
Actually, I've done that for probably the last year, and I was at a show back in December, I think, or November, and my mom was in the crowd, and she goes, 3 minutes and 48 seconds, Wayne. I spent some time in Nashville. And I'm originally from Beloit, as I said, and one of my songwriting buddies that I moved down there with was from Utica, Kansas, which is just a spot in the middle of nowhere in western Kansas. But I met him out in Hayes, and we moved to Nashville to do some songwriting. And so we could write songs like nobody's business. We would get together, and things would just pop off. And most of the original songs that I have for you today are probably songs that we wrote. But we wanted to write something that was basically about Belleville or Beloit or something. Red brick roads, the feeling it is to come from a small town. And so the problem, in my opinion, with country music today is it doesn't paint pictures. It doesn't tell stories anymore. And I love story songs that just take you down a road. And so this is a song called Where It All Began. Before a lot of people got here, that it was so nice to actually play in a place where people are listening, because so many times there's a lot of drunks and they're loud and they drown you out, and then they want you to turn the PA down, but you can't hear yourself because people are being so loud. Well, what'd you say? Exactly.
Well, is your home place still in existence?
Beloit?
Well, I mean, the county is where you grew up.
It is, but it's been sold. My mom and dad have moved out of it and moved on. a smaller house. And so, yeah. But you know, memories last forever, right?
Yep.
And then you just immortalize them in a song. They're like my little babies, and they just pick them up, and they just move along to the next town. And play. This next song, I wrote this over 20 years ago, and it literally took me 30 minutes to write. I don't know where it came from. This is one of those ones, and it just, everywhere I go, it doesn't matter how many songs I play. If I play some originals, somebody always wants to hear this song. It's just very poignant, the way it's just so simple and of an idea. And the thing about the song is, I remember when I wrote it, I was driving into Nashville with a buddy, and we were going to a songwriting contest, and he says, "So what song are you going to play?" And I said, "Well, listen to this." And I put this tape in. The song was less than 24 hours old. He said, "Well, that's a good song," he said, "but you're an idiot." He says, "You never enter a song into a songwriting contest that you just wrote the day before without several rewrites." And I said, "Well, I'm gonna enter it." And I think there was like 30 entries, and this one won the songwriting contest 24 hours after it was written, and it's never been rewritten at all. And this song's called Jenny. Jenny said she loved me. I neglected every word. I was young and carefree. Affection was absurd. I was just a boy. She was just a girl. I was weak. She was strong. Jenny changed my world. I fought the fear inside me. Fought the laughter from my friends. They caught me kissing Jenny. They saw me hold her hand. But they were just schoolboys, busy chasing squirrels. But I was chasing Jenny, 'cause Jenny changed my world. She put my life in motion, turned my world around. Took the place of heaven, put heaven on the ground. All that once was important never seemed the same to me. Jenny unlocked my heart. Jenny owned the key. Jenny died in 92. She never was my wife. I found the strength to make it through the hard times in my life. Now I'm married to a woman. We have a little girl. We named the baby Jenny, and Jenny changed my world. She put my life in motion, turned my world around. Took the place of heaven, put heaven on the ground. All that once was important never seemed the same to me. Jenny unlocked my heart. Jenny owned the key. All that once was important never seemed the same to me. Jenny unlocked my heart. Jenny owned the key. You gotta kill somebody off in a song to grab hearts, right? So, it's Sunday. It's God's day, right? I'm gonna play some worship songs. How's that sound? Let's play some Christian music, okay? If you feel like worshiping the Lord, that's perfectly fine. I got a couple originals in here as well, so. Thank you. So when I'm not doing this, I do have a real job. No, it's not music business. I actually play worship at my church, which they graciously gave me the day off today to come serve you people. But I do want to let you know that I am the biggest Chiefs fan that there is. Okay, so go Chiefs. So when Katrina contacted me and asked me about playing on a Sunday, I seriously had to check the NFL schedule to make sure it was beyond the Super Bowl or any playoffs. And it all worked out good. Here's another one. This is called Your Grace Is Enough. Songs, I don't know where it came from. I was just in one of those places and just felt like, I don't know. And then sometimes you write it and you look back at the words and you go, what did that really mean? This is called I Rise.
Oh, the storm.